So sometimes we're given a coordinate in degrees, minutes, and seconds, and we need to convert that to decimal degrees. Why would we ever need to do that? Well, sometimes these numbers get a little bit complicated. You see, the problem is that we get these weird symbols. So we know that this is degrees, just like when we're cooking. And we know that this is going to be minutes, although it looks like feet. But it's going to be a single quotation mark, and the double quotation mark is seconds. So degrees, minutes, seconds, and then north. Entering these guys, especially this little symbol, gets a little bit wonky sometimes, right? In some applications, it's only going to be asking for decimal degrees. So it doesn't want degrees and minutes and seconds. And computers don't do all that well at doing this conversion that we're going to work our way through. So this is going to be a coordinate. I have it in degrees, minutes, and seconds, and I want to convert this to decimal degrees. Now, we call it degrees, minutes, and seconds, and it is convenient that it's similar to time because we know that there are 60 seconds in 1 minute, and there are 60 minutes in an hour, but we also know that it's going to be 60 minutes in 1 degree, okay? So if this were 30 seconds, then we would know that it would be 1/2 or 0.5 of a minute. If this were 30 minutes, we would know that that would be 1/2 of a degree or 0.5, okay? 15 minutes or seconds would be 1/4, right? And so on. So what are we doing there in our brain? Well, let's first start on the far right side. And we're gonna take that value and it's gonna give us seconds, but we wanna figure out minutes. So we're gonna divide by 60, right? So we're gonna take that 36 and we divide that by 60, and the solution that we get there is going to be 0.6. Okay, so what do we do with that? Well, we're gonna take whatever the results are, we're going to add that solution to the next column. To the left. Okay, so we've got that 0.6, and now what we're going to do is we're going to bump it over, we're going to add it to that, and I'm going to drop this guy down, so it's going to be 51 degrees, and I'm going to take 17 plus 0.6 will give me 17.6 minutes, and I want to always remember that direction that we're following. Okay, now the last step, so we started on the right side, we divide by 60, we add that solution to the next column, and then repeat if needed. In this case, we still have minutes and degrees, and so we do need to redo the process. So I'm going to take this particular value, I'm going to divide it by 60. That's going to give me 0.293. I'm going to take that value, add it to the next column over, and my solution is 51.293 degrees to the north. Should we do it again? Yeah, let's do it again for this guy.
So we have 115 degrees, 55 minutes, and 13 seconds. Right, that 13 seconds is gonna be really close to a quarter of a minute, but let's go ahead and crank through some numbers, right? So we're gonna take that 13, we divide it by 60. That's going to give us 0.216666, which we will put a 7. I'm gonna go with 3 significant digits. I take that, I add it to the next column over. This guy we're just gonna bring down, and so I've got 115 degrees, 55.217 minutes west. Do I need to repeat? I do, because they're not all over to degrees yet. So I take this guy, I divide it by 60, and it's going to give me 0.9202 blah, 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 blah. We're going to stop there. I add this to my next column over, and I get 115.920 degrees west.
All right. And so now we've taken our degrees, minutes, seconds, and converted them to decimal degrees. So Castle Mountain there in Alberta is at that degrees, but that is also going to be equal to 51.293 degrees north and 115.920, and that zero shows that we're being a little bit more accurate, degrees west.